streets tonight, and as you fall asleep, I'll send my glow like a blanket. I'll pull up the tide, count up all your satellites, and slip away as you turn awake. Just know I'll stand guard as the darkness comes and goes. If only you could see the way I do. Turn to me in your midnight blues. Gravity endlessly has me falling for you, always to you. I am just a lovesick stone, here in case you feel alone. Does it get as cold for you as me? How I wish that I could hold you near. Feel the breeze of atmosphere, waves of ocean blue and fields of green. You'll always be the colors of my dreams. If only you could see the way I do. Turn to me in your midnight blues. Gravity endlessly has me falling for you, always to you.
So much. We're so excited about you joining them together in this special covenant. Father, may this marriage preach the glorious reality of Christ and His church to anybody who has eyes to see. We pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Turn to each other. Well, welcome this beautiful evening. My name is Pastor Derek. On behalf of Terrence and Janet,
you look nice.
Want to thank all of you for coming this evening.
What's the matter?
We're gathered here in the sight of Sovereign God, who the Bible describes as holy, holy, holy. And in the sight of each of you as witnesses to this ceremony honoring the holy institution of marriage. Terrence and Janet stand here today to declare that God is sovereignly directed their steps in such a way to bring them to one another and to this moment. Terrence and Janet, I am so honored and privileged to be here, to be a part of this, to be leading this service tonight. I want to thank all of you for pouring into them, being there. You all have played a significant role getting them to this place. And I want all of you to know that they did not take this covenant lightly. We've spent many hours together in premarital counseling, these months leading up to today, talking about marriage, working through issues, praying for wisdom. What I love about both of you is your humility, your understanding that marriage is not easy, that you need God's help. And what I love about both of you is just your desire to do it God's way, to honor Him with your lives. That is awesome, and I pray that will never change. Continue to put Him first, and may He be your greatest treasure. Friends, there's so much confusion in our culture right now regarding what marriage is and who created it. Marriage is not the invention of man. It is not a contract that you can enter in and out of. It is not a business agreement, and it is not even about an individual's happiness. The Bible teaches that marriage was created by God between one man and one woman for His glory. It is meant to be a living picture of the gospel of Jesus Christ. Throughout Scripture, Jesus is referred to as the groom and the church, His bride. The groom, Jesus, expressed His love for His bride in absolute self-sacrifice, displaying continually a love that knows no end. Jesus loved us, even when we weren't deserving. While we were His enemies, He loved us sacrificially. May this be true of your guys' marriage. The bride, the church, expresses her love to Him by accepting His love, number one, by trusting in His love, and by acknowledging Christ as her leader and gladly following Him where He leads. It's obedience. The Bible teaches that once you have faith in Him and you become part of His bride, that you are yoked to Him for all of eternity. He never divorces us. The Bible says once you trust in Christ, nothing can separate you from Him. He never gives up on us no matter what happens. May your marriage be a picture to the world of this special covenant. Ephesians 5 says this, "Wives, submit to your own husbands as to the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, as also Christ is the head of the church. He is the Savior of the body. Therefore, just as the church is subject to Christ, so let the wives be to their own husbands in everything. Husbands, love your wives, just as Christ also loved the church, gave Himself for her that He might sanctify and cleanse her with the washing of water and by the word, that He might present her to Himself a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that she should be holy and without blemish. Husbands ought to love their own wives as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself, for no one ever hated his own flesh, but nourishes it, cherishes it, just as the Lord does the church. We are members of His body, His flesh, and His bones. This is a great mystery, but I speak of Christ and His church." Terrence, I want to say to you this evening that this is your bride. As her father walked her down the aisle and gave her away moments ago, that was no mere formality. It wasn't just simply symbolic. Something is changing here today. You have a new responsibility. You are to love her to the point of absolute self-sacrifice. Your love is to know no end. You are her provider and you are her protector. Genesis chapter 2, 24. "For this reason, a man shall leave his father and his mother, be joined to his wife, and they shall become one flesh. And the man and his wife were both naked and were not ashamed." Terrence, today you are entering into a covenant with God, promising Him you will love Janet the way that God loves you, unconditionally and eternally. Jenna, I want to speak to you this evening. This is your husband. No one has forced you to be here. As He loves you like Christ, you are to joyfully submit to Him, to trust Him, to follow His leadership. Allow His protection and provision to be a covering for you, a place of refuge. Today, you are entering into a covenant with God, promising Him you're going to love Terrence the way that God loves you, unconditionally and eternally. I want to encourage both of you at this time to continue to look to God for compassion, kindness, gentleness, patience, humility. As issues come up, which they will in every marriage, my prayer for you and will continue to be that you follow Colossians 3:13. Forgive each other quickly. Do not let the sun go down without resolving the issue. Keep asking God to bring a greater love in your heart for Him and for each other. And I want you to take a moment and look around. God has blessed you. Be thankful for the friends and the family that He has given you. What a blessed life and God's faithfulness to be to both of you. So at this time, we're going to exchange the vows. Terrence, will you take Janet to be your lawful wedded wife? Do you promise to love, comfort, honor, and keep her for better, for worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, adversity, prosperity, and forsaking all others, to be faithful only to her so long as you both shall live?
I do.
Amen. Janet, will you take Terrence to be your lawful wedded husband? Do you promise to love, comfort, honor, and keep him for better or worse, for richer, poorer, in sickness and in health, adversity or prosperity, forsaking all others, to be faithful only to him so long as you both shall live?
I guess so, yes.
All right. At this time, we could have the rings. The ring is an outward symbol of an inward commitment that you are making to each other right now. These rings are special because they reflect God's unending love for you and your unending love for each other. As you look at these rings from now on, remember this day where you made these vows to each other. It's your advertisement to the world that you are no longer one, but you belong to each other and you are trusting God to fulfill this commitment. So Terrence, take this ring. Give this ring to Janet. Repeat after me. Janet with this ring.
Janet with this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
I pledge my life.
I pledge my life.
And love to you.
And love to you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And the Son.
The Son.
And the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
I have to say hello.
Yep. You're next.
Is it on?
Good job. Here.
I don't know if I can do it with my nails.
Yeah. Titus, you might be helping here. Left.
Yeah.
Left. Yeah.
All right.
We got some nails to work with here, so we're gonna trust the Lord. All right. We believe in miracles. Amen. All right. We'll let you go. All right, Janet. Give this ring to Terrence. Repeat after me. Terrence with this ring.
Terrence with this ring.
I be wed.
I be wed.
I pledge my life.
I pledge my life.
And love to you.
And love to you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And the Son.
The Son.
And the Holy Spirit.
The Holy Spirit.
Good job. Thank you. They're going to participate in a unity candle, a ceremony. And what you're about to see is they have committed their lives together to one another. Today, you join your separate lives together. The two separate candles here, lit, hopefully staying lit, will symbolize your separate lives, separate families, separate set of friends. They represent all that you are and all that you will ever be as an individual. They also represent your lives before today. As these two candles are joined to light a third candle, the individual candles will no longer exist, but will be joined as one, symbolizing biblically two people together becoming one.
Yeah. Grab it. You ready? Good. Oh, that's a good sign.
Good job.
Thank you. All right, let's pray together. Father, I thank you for my friends. Grateful for them. I pray that you would bless them and keep them. That your face would shine upon them. Be gracious to them. I pray you bless their family. Fill their home with laughter and joy and peace and love. And what you have joined together this day, let no man separate. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Terrence, Janet, based on the charge you've received today, based on these vows that you have taken in the sight of God and these witnesses, now by virtue of the authority vested in me as a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, our Lord, in the presence of God and these witnesses, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Terrence, you may kiss your bride.
I found a love for me. Well, darling, just dive right in, follow my lead. Well, I found a girl, beautiful and sweet. Well, I never knew you were the someone waiting for me. 'Cause we were just kids when we fell in love, not knowing what it was. I will not give you up this time. Darling, just kiss me slow. Your heart is all I own, and in your eyes, you're holding mine. Baby, I'm dancing in the dark with you between my arms, barefoot on the grass, listening to our favorite song. When you said you looked a mess, I whispered underneath my breath that you heard it. Darling, you look perfect tonight. Well, I found a woman stronger than anyone I know. Shares my dreams, I hope that someday I'll share her home. I found the love to carry more than just my secrets, to carry love, to carry children of our own. We are still kids, but we're so in love, fighting against all.
Piper of R&B, y'all. Whoa. Follow me. Chicago and them.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Don Juan and them. Yeah. This is for y'all. The remix.
Said I know that it's somebody's birthday tonight.
Somewhere.
And I know somebody's gonna celebrate tonight.
Somewhere.
I know
one thing's for sure.
I'm gonna put on my dancing shoes.
Then I'ma hit the door
and go out and step the whole night through.
Step in the name of love.
I'm gonna
step in the name of love.
Then I'm gonna
step in the name of love.
Oh yeah. I'm gonna step
in the name of love.
Woo.
Step in the name of love.
In the name of
move
love.
In the name of love.
Yeah.
Move in the name of love.
See, I know there's somebody breaking out the champagne somewhere. And you can be sure that
be sure
somebody's gonna make love night until the day. Oh,
one thing's for sure.
I'm gonna put on my dancing shoes.
Then I'ma hit the door
and go out and step the whole night through.
Step in the name of love.
Yeah.
Step in the name of love.
Whoa.
Clap in the name of love.
Yeah.
Clap in the name of love.
Said I'm gonna step.
Step in the name of love.
Ooh.
Step in the name of love.
In the name
Move
of
in the name
love.
Of love.
Till somebody else gets up.
And I
wanna be the first one to hit the floor.
So
tell the DJ to turn it up.
Turn it up.
Cause it feels so good. Dancing to this remix makes me wanna step. Cause it's a cup.
Step in the name of love.
Oh, babe.
Step in the name of love.
Flow.
Step, step, side to side, round and round, dip it now, separate, bring it back. Now let me see you do
the love slide.
Step, 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 side to side,
keep on stepping,
round and round, dip it now,
whoa.
Step
round and round,
bring it back.
Side to
now
side,
let me see you do
separate,
the
and bring it
step
back.
Step, 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 side to side, round and round,
step
dip it now.
Come on and step in the name of
step,
love.
Bring it back.
While we're living, step steps out, hit the club. DJ's rocking that song for us. Is anybody act while we're stepping? Tell them that we did it for love, yeah. Did it for love, yeah.
Let me see you do.
Did it for love, yeah.
All right, I'm gonna play a little something for new to everybody, I guess. Where y'all at?
I love you endlessly. I'll always be here for you.
Amen.
And I am so proud of you.
Yes.
Beyond words, I am so proud of you.
Yes.
Just the woman that you have become.
Yes.
Yes. The mother that you are and the person that you are. You are beautiful from the inside out.
Yes.
One of your maid of honor, and I will do anything for you, and I'll do anything for you and Terrence. I'm always here for you, and I'm just so happy that you are together.
Yes.
And this day came today so beautifully, and we love you all very dearly, and may your union be blessed from today forever.
Yes.
And no matter what hardships or what
comes,
may your union be strong and everlasting. And we love you.
Yes.
I just want to say, Deanna, it was absolutely beautiful. And Terrence,
yes.
I never looked more handsome. For those of you who don't know me, for
For those who can't tell, I'm Janet's sister. Thank you, Janet, for the honor of being one of your maid of honors. Obviously, I've known Janet all my life, and we know more about each other than we would probably care to. We've laughed together, cried together, fought dozens of times. We also have plenty of memories that will leave you find funny. When Terrence and Janet started dating, I instantly gained a brother. From constant roasts to real-life talks, I know that I can always count on him. Janet and Terrence love one another today, as if tomorrow may not come. Marriage will never be perfect, but what do I know about that? I do know that trust, and honesty, and love will carry you a long way. We all love you. Cheers to the Hamiltons.
All right, Sid, my name is Nick. This is like my brother right here. They say water is the way the opportunity goes, blood thicker than water. Well, I feel like mud is thicker than blood. We've been through a lot of stuff. He's actually had to set me straight a few times. I mean, like, I'd do anything for this guy. With that being said, since I knew him, I met Janet a long time ago. I was like, there's something about this girl that I gotta keep her in my life. This must have been the reason. With that being said, I was actually the one that said, yo, I got a perfect girl for you. I got a perfect guy for you.
Cupid.
But no, I seriously felt like, you know, I see a lot of things in this world, and I'm just like, I got three things happening. That's my personality. Anybody who knows me? No. I'm gonna make shit happen. But being a married guy, I really feel like we've had our talks. You guys ever need advice? I'm not going to leave you straight. I'm going to make you guys stay together. Yeah. With that being said, toast.
Oh, yes, sir. Yes.
This is Janet Mao. I'm going to sing. Thank you for everybody who come and support us. My daughter, I'm proud of you. I came and I built you guys listening to me. I'm so happy you and Taryn to move forward and live life the way you want to be. And I'm gonna thank my husband to support me all things I did, because this man is a wonderful person to you guys. And I love you guys. And I love Tish and Tall. Thank you for support. You did it for those two girls. You guys are amazing. Thank you.
What's going on, y'all? For most of y'all that don't know, I'm Brandon. I'm Terrence's brother. His dad married my mom. But we've been together since third grade. I got to be honest with you. I really didn't know this day would come. He's a very strong-minded person. In order to hold him down, you need a strong-minded person. So I did. Janet, you are a beautiful woman inside and out. Like I was saying, I appreciate the woman that you are. I appreciate the bond that you all have. I love my nieces and nephews. I really got to tell y'all, listen, for the longest time, Terrence has been my protector. For many, many years, anybody that messed with me, I couldn't even get a chance to get to him because he cleaned him up first. That's the truth. I mean, cleaned him up, one-sided. So for me to be here today, it gives me a lot of honor. I feel blessed. And I got to tell you, bro, I love you a lot. And anything that you need, I always got your back. I want to make sure that I prove it to you through actions, not through words. To the Hamiltons.
Okay, so I'm Bernice. I am Jane's cousin, and I honestly have to admit, I am so proud of you. I am proud of the woman that you have become. I am proud of the mother that you have become. Terrence, I have my doubts. I ain't gonna lie. Doubts. I am so blessed to call you my brother-in-law. We are grateful to be a part of your family. Where we come from, marriage is forever. we are all here to make sure that this marriage stays till the end of time. Bless you, bless your womb, bless your fruits of labor, bless your home, bless everything that both of you put your hands together to do as one.
It's not easy being married. We know that for a fact.
We have families that are going through it. But one thing that I will say, and I did say yesterday, is never ever go to bed angry at each other.
Amen.
Love hard. The devil works harder to break the barrier. Especially when you know God has touched you in ways that he can't touch. We love you, we're here to support you, we will always be here for you. I just want to say I'm very proud of the both of you. God bless the both of you. Congratulations to the Hamiltons. Love you.
Love you too.
It's alright. You got it.
One more time.
Come on.
I can tell you guys, marriage is hard.
Yes.
Keep God first.
Amen.
And everything will be good. Do me a favor.
Uh-huh.
You're not leaving my sister.
I got the memo.
I'm going to come after you. She's my heart.
Got you.
Please.
She's a good hand.
Please.
I appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank both of you guys for just being there for me. Sometimes and stuff, Dana taking me in. Stepson and everything. I think she's done for me.
You mean my stepson? You my stepson? Yes!
Yes! Yes! Yes! My dad who guided me to be a better, to be a better man.
Having a wedding and having us in the family and stuff and everything.
As y'all begin y'all new journey in life, as we said today, you love your wife, you love your husband. I wish y'all many, many years of happiness, because I already know, because y'all both guys are happy. Y'all probably going to take a journey with you guys together. Y'all have to forgive me. I'm not good. I'm trying not to get teary-eyed up here. But,
you can let a tear fall.
I know. I'm trying not to. But let's give these guys a toast to the years of life.
Thank you. Yes, sir.
Stop.
taken.